chug, 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 chug,
Hello and welcome back to the Wizard Staff. I am your host, Blake.
And I'm Guy.
And as you can tell, I'm doing the intro this time because I'm going to be way better at it. We are the Wizard Staff. We are two drunk novices that like to talk about EDH. We drink and swear, so just letting you know, you've been warned. Drink responsibly out there.
When you're playing children's card games.
This episode is going to be about Infect, everybody's favorite mechanic. But before we get to it, we got to kind of address the elephant in the room. We're going to do a real quick talk about the CAG or CAG, the Commander Advisory Group, that thing. So real quick, basically the Rules Committee has got a ton of complaints over the years that they live in an ivory tower and are unaware of the average EDH player. So with that complaint, and with the format growing in popularity over the last couple years, the Rules Committee has decided to make the CAG. And the CAG is currently made up of 6 individual volunteers selected by the Rules Committee. There may be more in the future, but for now there's 6. All of them have pretty diverse backgrounds, which was on purpose so that you didn't just have an echo chamber and a group of yes men, like, saying, yeah, you're great, you're wonderful when you're doing shit. Some of these people the Rules Committee already knew, and some of these people the Rules Committee didn't know and interviewed. And I think that's a good thing. I have that balance of, it's not just people, they're friends that they're inviting, it's new people that they haven't met before. Overall, I think this is a good thing, but we're gonna leave it at that because we'll talk about it next episode more.
Stay tuned.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, but we gotta live in the moment, guys. We gotta live for the moment right now. And we're talking about Infect right now.
Infect? Like, what's that, Blake?
I don't know. Why don't you tell me?
Okay. <I'm dumb. laughs> Infect is a mechanic that creatures have and deal combat damage in the form of -1/-1 counters to players, to creatures, and to players in the form of poison counters. It's important to note that these counters are permanent. They don't leave a creature at the end of the turn, so it's almost as if a creature attacks and passes on a sickness to another creature.
It's like they've been infected.
What? If dealt to a player, that player then takes infect damage, and then when a player receives 10 infect damage, they die. So, to give a little history about Infect, it was originally released in Scars of Mirrodin. Each creature with Infect and all cards that have Infect or positively affect creatures with Infect are printed with the Phyrexian watermark. Phyrexia is an artificial plane of mechanical and biomechanical life, so an ecosystem comprised of metal, death, and tissue. A hellish world with an accelerated evolution of artifact creatures. It's also known as the Machine Hell and the Nine Hells.
Sounds like a nice place.
As with its related mechanic, Proliferate, Infect is Phyrexian completely in 15. And Proliferate is the ability to add counters onto every permanent of one kind. So when you proliferate, you're able to increase permanent that has a counter and give it one more. So if Blake has 8 infect counters and I am able to proliferate, I can give him one more so he has 9. Or you could even do proliferate on planeswalkers with their loyalty abilities, or just any other kind of counters.
Any counters anywhere, except for experience counters, I think.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Some of those really popular proliferate cards are Atraxa, who is the most popular commander of all the commanders, Contagion Engine and Contagion Clafts, and then Throne of Geth's another one. But so there was the mechanic Poisonous, which was basically Infect, but it was only printed on 2 cards really on the early days, Snake Cult Initiation and Virulent Silver. Sliver.
Virulent, you got this time.
Sliver.
You can do it every time.
Yeah, I confuse the slivers and the silvers. Well, there's no silvers, but I just am dyslexic when I read it and think that it says silvers, not slivers. Anyway, Mark Rosewater, who is one of the head designers at Wizards of the Coast, is on record of saying how much he loves Infect because it provides an alternate win condition to the game, which seems to be a common theme for him, but that flavor of Infect really works well, and he felt it needed more love when it came to this set because there were only two Infect cards out there, because he often thought that the Phyrexians were kind of like the Lex Luthor of the villains in the in like the planes of magic. And so he thought, how can, you know, what's the good way to make them scary is by having this kind of like poison that they're able to transfer onto other creatures and players, or planeswalkers, I guess, because people are planeswalkers. I also have a suspicion that we might see more Infect coming this year because of how excited Mark is for the year. It would be cool to see, in my opinion. I mean, I may even like to see like a pre-con built around Infect when it comes to like Commander, and then maybe all the pre-cons have some kind of theme revolve around these alternate win cons like Mill, Voltron, Infect, but that's being hopeful from my perspective. That has nothing to do with what we're talking about today.
Yeah. I didn't know that, like, Mark was saying that 2019 was going to be, like, the best year of Magic, and, like, I didn't know that was happening.
Yeah, he and Gavin are both on record of saying, of like, how exciting they both think, design-wise, Magic has kind of proven itself for this year. So I'm excited to see what that actually means for the game.
Okay, now I'm actually hyped. I mean, I'm always hyped for this game, and I'm invested into this game, but I hope they live up to what they say.
Yeah, Magic's like kind of living in a continuous idea of just anticipating what's coming next. Now we're going to go into some of the popular Infect cards and some of the commanders that often revolve around Infect. We got commanders Atraxa, Saskia the Unyielding, Skithrix the Blight Dragon, or often known as Skittles, Izuri Claw of Progress, Mimeoplasm, Kasido, Oroki Archmage, and Rafik of the Many. Then for, oh my god, I did it again. Blake, what are we drinking tonight?
Oh shit, we did it again, yeah. So every episode we talk about what we're drinking. So I am drinking, thank you guy, because I was totally just going to forget. I am drinking Kraken Black Spiced Rum, and the bottle is literally the size of my own head.
And Blake's going to drink it all this episode.
No.
God, it's almost halfway gone.
Shush. Maybe. Maybe.
I guess off theme for a while, where normally I'm drinking either a Guinness or white wine. Tonight I'm drinking red wine. It's a Cabernet Sauvignon.
I don't think I can pronounce that right now, but okay. Yeah.
Perfect. All right. Yeah. So, okay, we got popular commanders. Now some popular cards. Contagion Engine, Contagion Class, Hand of the Praetors, Phyrexian Crusader, Spinebiter, Triumph of the Hordes, Grafted Exoskeleton, Blighted Agent, Blight Steel Colossus.
Yeah, our boy.
The mascot of the Wizard staff, Blight Steel Colossus. Yeah, just like how Josh Lee Kwai always talks about Vidalcan Ori or Fate Stitcher, Blight Steel Colossus is probably our most talked about card.
Yeah, I feel like that's a very good comparison.
Then we got Corrupted Conscience, Hatred, and Caressa Phyrexia. So, Blake, do you have anything you want to say about some of these cards?
Yeah, so I'm going to start with Triumph of the Hordes. It's a green sorcery, and if anyone actually wins with Infect, it's usually because of this card, in my experience. Like, of all the ways to win with Infect, it's usually people playing this in, like, green stompy decks and just trampling you to death, but some of that trample is Infect, and you die. So this is, in my mind, a key Infect card.
It also gives the creatures +2/+2, doesn't it?
Yes, yeah. It gives them, like, +2/+2.
Makes them have trample and Infect, which, if you have a lot of creatures, like, oftentimes you want to play this with, like, Craterhoof Behemoth.
Oh, that's just dirty. Don't do me like this. No. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Then another card is Grafted Exoskeleton, and I see other people talk about this as, like, a key Infect card, but I mostly see it, like, run as a backup win condition, since it's an artifact you can be put in any deck. I've yet to see it work at all. And then you... Yeah, but then you... Yeah, guy, tell him.
Okay. So Blake wrote these notes, and then I went to a local game store for the first time in, like, 2 months.
I'm so proud.
I played my Jolta deck, which I've talked about how I haven't gotten to play yet, just because of how, like, lonely I am when it comes to playing Magic. So anyway, I played Jolta, and in my deck, I ran Grafted Exoskeleton. And so I was able to get Jolta out pretty quickly, and then I got Grafted Exoskeleton also, and just equipped that bad boy to my Jolta, and it became a 14/14 Infect Commander, and boy, oh my god, did it feel so good to just swing in and kill people for lethal.
This giant green infecting dinosaur.
Yeah, just imagine, like, a dinosaur with, like, a mechanical exoskeleton on it. Damn.
Yeah, so... It's like, this never happens, and then Guy's like, hold my beer.
Hold my wine.
Yeah.
Or hold my Guinness, okay. I guess, to be a little more specific.
Yeah. I guess, I mean, do I really need to talk about Blightsteel Colossus? He's big, he's infecting, he just kills... Like, we were talking about it, and it's like, it's weird how it's like an 11-11.
I have thought about this a lot, and I think it's an 11-11. Since the idea of Blightsteel Colossus is just this giant golem with Infect that's trying to kill you, why is it an 11-11 and not just 10, which would kill a person on the spot? And I think it's an 11-11 just for the chance that if your opponent has like a Llanowar Elves or some kind of just 1-1 chump blocker, that Blightsteel Colossus will be able to still trample over 10 Infect damage onto your opponent. So it'll need something a little bigger than just, you know, Stormcrow or something that's... Because the idea is just Blightsteel Colossus is supposed to be a one-hit KO kind of card.
Is there any cards that you wanted to talk about, Guy?
Well, Blake, as you know, I run an Infect deck, so I love a lot of these cards. I want to... Caressa Phyrexia is a card that I've already talked about in our Mono Black Pet cards. It's the one that allows the player to draw 3, lose 3 life, and then gain 3 poison counters. Really nice. Hatred, which is a black instant that allows you to pay X life and give your creature X +1/+1, is a really nice card as well. It's a very popular card just because you're able to use it at instant speed, and right before you hit your opponent, you just play it and then kill them for lethal. And then Grafted Exoskeleton, which I've mentioned, I have been able to win with. And then a card that I think is cool in flavor, Corrupted Conscience. I haven't had the chance to play with it, but it's really sweet because you're able to take an opponent's creature, but even as you take that opponent's creature, you're giving the creature Infect, which is just really nice, and it's kind of like a upside from Treachery.
It's pretty good. I like it.
Me too. All right. So now we're going to go into strategies when playing with Infect, something that I happen to know a lot about, just because I run an Infect deck. So the first is run a lot of Proliferate. Since this ability was made for Infect, running Proliferate cards like Contagion Clasp, Contagion Engine, Throne of Geth are pretty crucial to rack up more Infect counters on a player. So a card like Icarats, which involves no interaction when playing, gives all your opponents, and I guess yourself, a poison counter, and then you can just start proliferating from there and get them up to 10. Because you're able to choose who gets more counters and who doesn't when you proliferate. It's not just everyone gets another one, you get to choose. So you can just have your opponents be going up in poison counters instead of having yourself go up. So we got that. Holding back. Being aggro in an Infect deck doesn't really help when you are against the odds. People tend to pick on you real quick, kind of like Arch Enemy. I remember a time when I was playing Infect and I was holding back really hard, but I was just getting picked on really early games since I was like the Infect guy. And until the game progressed and someone else became a much more prominent threat, I wasn't really able to do anything or even like attack because they would see that as a threat. So once, you know, people laid off me a little, I was then able to like go in and take out two players pretty quickly, and then that put me in second for a 5-player game. I want to clarify that when I mean don't be aggro, I mean don't be aggro early game and only going in when you're ready for a one-shot kill. Since most Infect cards tend to have less than 3 power, you need a lot of creatures or pumps in order to get there. So other than Blightsteel Colossus being one of the big boy exceptions, most cards you want to then try and just get them up as strong and as fast as you can. So it's not like you hit someone for 2 and they're like, oh, that's 2 Infect, and they're able to see it coming. When you're getting up to 10, it's just a one hit or nothing.
Yeah, you don't really want to hit someone with your Infect creature and then they're looking at you and they're like, all right, we need to stop him before he just kills us really easily. And then you're just fucked for the rest of the game, all because you tried to go off too fast. Infect can't really win fast.
No. You don't want to give them that opportunity that would allow you to almost like let your guard down. And then the last strategy for playing Infect is teaming up. So teaming up with someone is also a good idea, just because when you have pseudo protection or an ally that won't kill you and hopefully be able to protect you for a little bit while you get to a position where you can start taking out your other opponents is really nice. Personally, this hasn't worked too well for me just because I haven't played as many multiplayer games with Infect. A lot of the Infect games I played have been one-on-one. So just learning how to politic and think fundamentally how this can work out well for you.
All right, so now that we know how to play Infect, much more important, how do we play against Infect? So just how you can team up with Infect, you can also team up against Infect, even better. You just like turn to your like person next to you and you'd be like, hey, that person's playing Infect, want to kill him? And they're like, yeah, okay. And then you kill him. Easy peasy.
I don't know, that kind of sounds like bullying to me. Don't hate on someone for just playing a mechanic, Blake.
Don't turn my words against me.
I will do exactly that.
Then there are also some cards that just directly screw over Infect. One of which is... okay, I'm not too drunk. I think I can pronounce this. Malira Silvok Outcast. I did it. Yeah, so she is a legendary green creature. And she pretty much says, like, creatures can't get -1/-1 counters. And players can't get Infect counters or something like that. And it's literally just there to say, fuck you to Infect. It just directly fucks you over.
Yeah, the one thing I'd like to say is if you make this your commander, it's kind of then hard to like have like an actual win strategy that's not any kind of green normal win condition. You really are just kind of building a deck around this so that you are able to screw over someone else in your meta for playing Infect.
If you're playing her as the commander, yeah. Then another one is another card that directly screws over Infect is Solemnity, which I have right here with me because I bought it and I love it. It is 2 and a white enchantment that says players can't get counters. Counters can't be put on artifacts, creatures, enchantments, or lands. So, players can't get Infect counters. Yeah. Finger guns.
Dumb.
Dumb.
Dumb, dumb, dumb.
I may or may not have bought this just because Guy built Skittles. It's a side tech card. It's spicy. Yeah. Then the last card that specifically fucks over Infect is Leeches, which is 1 and white sorcery that says target player loses all poison counters on them. Yeah, it just removes them all, like Leeches taking out the poisoned.
Just like Malira, Leeches isn't a card, or like Solemnity, it's not a card that you should just run always. It's a card that you should run as a kind of backup if you're playing against Infect. It would be like a sideboard kind of card rather than like a main deck kind of card.
Yeah. If you're actually playing this, it's because there's someone in your meta that plays Infect and you're literally just saying, fuck you. Like, you're just being really passive aggressive instead of saying, hey, I don't like it. I don't like your Infect deck. You're just being like, okay, I'll build this deck that just says fuck Infect.
Yeah. And like, I believe Leeches is the only known card that takes away Infect counters. So if you cast Malira when you have, like, let's say 6 counters on yourself, she's not going to get rid of those counters, but she's not going to allow you to get more.
So now that we've kind of said those super specific cards, like, more broadly, how do you deal with Infect? More broadly speaking, how do you deal with Infect? So basically, you want to run things that hurt blue, black, green, and include some artifact and enchantment removal. Because if you actually look at the list, there's a lot of Infect cards. Most of them are small creatures. So anything that gets rid of small creatures, like wrath effects, targeted creature removal, they're gone, they're done. They're pretty weak. They're pretty easy to get rid of. A lot of other Infect cards are artifacts that either have Infect, give Infect, or proliferate. So just run some artifact removal. And then there are a few auras, like the blue one and the black ones, and just run enchantment removal. Yeah, it's every deck should be playing enchantment and artifact removal. So if you build your deck good, you'll deal with Infect anyway.
Right. It's not like Infect is some way out of their mechanic that no one can deal with ever. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty standard mechanic that just happens to kind of kill you quicker, but it's still doable and easy to deal with.
So let's talk about the pros and cons controversy of Infect.
Yes, so going into our pros, other people don't have fun when playing with the game. Oh wait, is that just for me?
Yeah.
Oh. Maybe that's more of a con. When someone plays Infect, most people then don't tend to have as much fun. Alternate win con is another pro, because in case one player happens to get like a ridiculous amount of life or has some kind of like really good protection, Infect is a way of being able to take someone out when they become too overpowered. Player removal is the best removal.
Yep, that's gonna be on my tombstone when I'm 6 feet under. That's gonna be right there as I say it all the time.
And so the last pro to Infect is that it creates interesting games and politics.
Yeah.
So one way that I tend to play Infect in a multiplayer game, as I've mentioned, is that I try and negotiate or politic my way to helping out someone else. And that way I can win or have some kind of like pseudo protection. And then after being given this protection, I'm then able to like focus all my energy on just one person, and that makes it a lot easier. There are cards like the Atraxa and Saskia, though, which tend to, you know, if you have Atraxa, you're able to proliferate every turn, or Saskia, who, you know, you do 10 infect one player, and Saskia allows you to then name another player, and you can do 10 infect to them, so taking out two instead of one. So yeah.
Two birds with one stone. Nice.
Yeah, so there are some pros to infect. Want to go into the cons, Blake?
Oh, you like went out of camera. I'm like, where'd he fucking go? I'm just like, you just...
I was laying down because I was like, okay, now it's Blake's turn to talk.
Nope, okay. Yeah, so some of the cons, the downsides to infect. Like, to kind of talk about your last point, a con would definitely be, like, the politics can backfire, where you aren't good at politicking, and they're just like, nah, we're just gonna kill you, and you're like, well, shit. Because you really do need to find someone to, like, buddy up with and be like, hey, at least have one ally in the game, or at least have someone who's neutral against you, or with you. Yeah. You cannot have archenemy, so politics, being able to politic well is important.
Bring your stacks friend, so it can just be, hey, let's pick on the stacks player, not me, the infect guy, haha.
I'll let Park know you said that. A con to playing multiplayer is that unless you aren't the threat, you are the threat, so it's like, don't put yourself out there until you're ready to win and kill everybody.
Right, because especially when I put Skittles into the middle of the table,
everyone's like, it has infect, kill it, kill it, kill it with fire.
Yeah, it's, you just kind of broadcast to everyone else that you're playing infect, and they're not going to give you the benefit of the doubt like 9 out of the 10 times, because they're like, oh, we know exactly what this fucker's going to do.
Yeah, I think when it's very obvious that you're playing an infect-centric deck, when you sit down and like you're taking out your cards and you put your commander into play, everyone's looking at each other and you're like, oh wait, this has infect. And then people in their minds have this like ranking order in terms of like, I think most people do, it's kind of debated, but it's like, I think most people have like, all right, this is probably the most powerful and this is like the least powerful, so I'm gonna probably go after this person first. And I think people tend to put infect way more powerful than it actually is. So when they sit down and be like, Skittles, oh, I'm going after this fuck.
Right.
Yeah, this kind of goes into the controversy of infect, that everyone kind of bitches about the fact that it only takes 10 infect counters to kill somebody. I can kind of see what they're saying, where like, oh, I just lose to like 10 points of this special damage and I'm dead and I'm out. That's dumb. But it's like, you gotta think from the person who's playing that infect deck, they have to do that like 2 or 3 more times, depending how big the EDH pot is. And it's like, that's not easy at all. It's like, when's the last time like you remember an infect player winning, honestly?
Right.
It doesn't happen.
Something that I've done, especially when I played with Ethan one-on-one, is that I bump up the counters to 15. Just because our games would be really quick if it was just 10. So giving the players the benefit of the doubt during that time, I can understand. But again, if you are playing infect, you're the arch enemy. You're already kind of like painting a... You're not even like painting a target on your back. You're almost like inviting people to just like...
Hit me! Come on! I'm right here!
Yeah, It's like when Batman is trying to, like, run at the Joker, you know?
I don't know.
Oh my god, Blake. Watch a fucking movie. The Dark Knight?
Yeah, maybe. I'm not remembering what you're thinking.
It's when the Joker's like in the middle of the street and he's like, hit me, hit me, hit me.
Oh yeah, okay, now I remember. Okay. I want you to do it. Come on.
Yeah.
Maybe a bit intoxicated. I'm sorry, folks.
Okay. But anyway, so playing Infect and like just having it known out there makes you that target. So it's not like, oh, it's going to be a surprise. But, and like we've mentioned, in my head, I can only tell you that there are three creatures that have more than four power and have Infect. And that's Scythrix, Phyrexian Juggernaut, and Blightsteel Colossus. And
there's also Putrefax, but that dies at the end of the turn.
Oh, so...
Yeah.
That doesn't even count.
Yes. Anyway, we're going to move on to the next segment, which is my favorite segment of this episode, because it's titled Blake Bitches. So, I get to bitch about this. So, in my 4 years of playing EDH, Infect has won four games. Four games. In those four games, two were Azuri Claw Progress as the commander with some small Infect creatures that get pumped by Azuri. Another one was one with Triumph of the Hordes, which I spoke about earlier. Another game was one with Blightsteel Colossus. That's it. Over 4 years, Infect has won four times. And I just want to say, like, I don't just play with my friends. I do go to multiple LGSs, like, every week and see new stuff constantly. So it's not like I'm just in a bubble. Like, I get around there. that sounded bad. Anyway, Infect is not OP and should stay at 10. Infect is fine. I would make the argument that Infect is often more powerful as a backup win condition that nobody sees coming versus telegraphing it out there.
Yeah, I think you do it really nicely in your Phage deck, where Phage is a creature that will kill someone just by hitting them once. Yep. There's a lot of conditions to Phage, which makes it a lot more balanced. But then you also have Blightsteel Colossus in that deck, which is like a backup just in case if Phage doesn't work out.
Phage almost never wins, but when she does, I'd say almost half of them are actually because of Blightsteel or Skittles, because I'm making stuff unblockable anyway, and haste, so it's like, why not? And it works. I do want to say recently, I played at a store, my opponent cast Blightsteel Colossus, they made two copies of it, swung at me, I survived, and on my turn, I cast Insurrection, taking all creatures on the board, and then I killed all my opponents. So, technically, over the last 4 years, I've seen it five times.
And one of those times was yourself.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I've seen it win a lot more times just because, personally, I play it, and I've won. I don't think I've ever won a multiplayer pod with Infect, unless I count the one time I played with people and did like the King version, where you're trying to take out one specific person. But other than that, oftentimes, because I'm playing Infect, I'm the one who gets targeted, which I'm used to, so it's fine. Now we're going to move into Guy Bitches Even Harder. So, one of the first times I was playing Magic, I was using my Precon Ur-Dragon deck. I had upgraded it a bit, and one of those upgrades included Skittles. So during a game, I was able to get Skittles out and start swinging at my opponent pretty easily. And after quickly getting him to 8 counters, with him not doing anything to try and stop that, he started to complain that it wasn't fair, and I felt bad, so I stopped hitting him with the card, but then he immediately turned it around and took me out of the game, since he had took advantage of what I consider my good nature, because I didn't want to feel like an asshole for killing him that way, but I also didn't want to feel like a, you know, bad winner, because he would have been like a sore loser for complaining that's why he lost. So I definitely felt this was like a dick thing to do to me. Rather, I was only playing one infect card at this time, and it just happened to be Skittles. Then I went on to make my Skittles deck. Now, I will admit that might not have been the best response, because at the beginning of playing Magic, I was with a lot of people who were still playing pretty new. I don't think Infect is a mechanic that you should show new players or like try to get new players involved with, just because it can be considered kind of bullshit to lose to 10 in more competitive or more experienced game sets. I think that people know how to properly threat assess and realize that, okay, Infect's not as bad as we're making out to be. So, word of advice for future players, don't try and teach someone Magic, but also then kill them to Infect really quick, because that's not gonna, you know, give them a fun time.
Yeah, similar to how you don't wanna, like, be teaching someone Magic and then immediately, like, show them stacks, or have them play against your stacks deck. Don't immediately play against them and kill them with your Infect deck. Just wait a little bit for that. That being said, Guy, that just means you were ahead of the curve. It's like you were two steps ahead of everybody else, because you're like, oh, let me just skip to this mechanic that everybody kind of hates.
Right. So Blake's calling me a genius right now.
God,
anyway,
damn, no.
So we're going to get into the conclusion. Infect is a mechanic like any other. It has its strengths and weaknesses. It's not unbeatable. Not every single deck may be able to counter it as hard as some others, but with the group dynamics of EDH, which is what the game's all about, there has to be some way that you can work together and take out Infect. Talking with the table and figuring out what is best is the real solution, just like any other problem that you would see. And even if like the Infect deck somehow is just way too overpowered, maybe ask the player to then only play it maybe one out of the three games that they play every night. So
people have said that they don't like dying so easily to Infect, which I kind of find to be a piss poor excuse or argument, because there are like such crazy things that happen on EDH. Like, honestly, like, there are some absurd wacky things that happen. Like, are you really going to make that argument on Infect? Of all the things to complain about being unfair, it's like, you're really going to complain about Infect? Stop.
Yeah.
Like, it's fine. It's fine. It's a mechanic like any other. I guess one thing of note is, like, Josh Lee Kwai from the Command Zone has said that with his friend Craig, who always plays Infect in every deck, their meta has learned to anticipate and counter that strategy. They play a bunch of, like, early game blockers in all their decks now. And I think that's like a really good example of someone introduces a really powerful mechanic and your meta just kind of adapts to it, and you learn to become a better Magic player because of it. And I think that's what everyone should take away from it instead of just complaining about it all the time.
I agree.
So with that being said, thank you for listening to our episode 17 Infect. We love you guys. You can find us on YouTube and iTunes now, and
make sure to follow us on Twitter.
Yeah, we post a whole bunch of memes on Twitter that are actually funny. So thank you guys again, and we'll see you guys next episode. Peace out.
Peace. Come on.